a big girthy white one. Take a look at the pack. Go for projectile. And then, of course, you can get leveling. The thing we're going to take a look at is the attributes, because I always forget. So just like the other, the Demon of Souls insta-give attack with all the attack speed. Bears that, you know, give me health. Resists, attack. Attack speed. You want attack speed everywhere. Everywhere, anywhere. You can get it. Love. Loves. Shoulders. axis, your enemies don't really move at all. And of course, you can get the juicy explosions. And that's all you do. At all. Okay, you're basically just running around and shooting. Alright, so you see how slow that mofo's going? When you couple that with stasis, your enemies don't really move. At all. And of course, you can get the juicy explosions. And that's all you do. Explosions. Explosions. It's very simple gameplay. You do have to be active in terms of dodging and running, because for some reason Havoc Orb has a minimum range. You can't shoot it directly in front of you. It'll always go a little bit like out to here. So you are gonna wanna position yourself well. So what do we got here? What do we got here? We got a big boy here. Perfect. So drop that. Smack that. He's slowed. He's dead. Before he even has a chance to act. Now granted, this is obviously just a level 20 quest. Slows enemies to a crawl if it doesn't stop them in their tracks. Aetherite, you can apply stasis. It's called Shaded. Shaded, which that's just open. Stasis coupled with Sticky Bomb. Crawl if it doesn't. And since you're kind of squishy as a pistol character, you want as many defensive options as you can get. So yeah, for the skills, the more Mark of Impurity, once again, you switch. It's situational, so single target, you want to go with the first two. Increased damage and vulnerability and slow. And for general purpose AoE clearing, like if you're in a group, you go with the corpse explosion and the spread, which is beautiful. It's so good.
Hello. Sorry. chilled on drink. Challenged Hebos. so bad. kurwa. Gothic pistol.
How's it going, everybody? Some on a save and video for levels. Now you just look at this and you can already see why it's amazing. It's got status ailment chance score. It's got dodge chance score. It's got all attributes. It's got attack and spell crit. And if that wasn't enough, it's also got magic find. You can get this belt with a level requirement of as low as 10. Now I continue to use this belt well into actually leveling, like past leveling, into expeditions, all that good stuff. Or brooch if you're nasty. This gives you move speed, dodge chance score, and agility at the cost of a reduced stamina generation. I don't know what's more defensive. It's got global life leech. That means any damage you do, you'll leech from it. Now I know leech is kind of, you get a whopping 140 to 150 or 1. The rest, I'm just throwing this, has no level requirement, but ferocity and a base. I think the damage increase is well worth the reduced attack speed. especially if you're like going all agility and you're pumping a ton of attack speed anyway, that can, you know, counterbalance the minus 22% attack speed on it. I think the range is like minus 25 to 20, I think. Not 100% sure. Either way, still a good ring, still worth using. Still gangster. And that's it. Just wanted to make a quick video. All right, you ding dongs. I am going to do a plus 13. Enjoy. An arrows whale. So I have discovered the secret to immortality. It has nothing to do with the Philosopher's Stone. Stone templates to level 20. Tank. So, first things first, I'll show you the passive tree. A multiplayer ability to cast sacred spells, and Bulwark of Dawn is a sacred spell. So, Bulwark of Dawn using, and then the leap, all rolls, what should really work, so ignore it. Just take it for the 10% added block chance, and then grab a little bit more block chance. You will need this specific shield, the Quintet of Sundowns, because it allows the bearers to cast sacred spells, and Bulwark of Dawn is a sacred spell. So, if you just want that extra healing over time, and a bit of resistance, or whatever else you want to use, you know, you need the Bulwark. If not, any random shield will do, whatever's best. Thank you. And of course, bleeding edge, you just want to...
arrows without drop, like always. This mean? I don't know. Do I have some force shields?
Oh,
Ah, niech to mi się grać.